For all the actors, particularly, I have to Arun can join, but tomorrow and on next week also, one lecture will be taken. Either by Dr. Karna or Mauli or Kushal or Dr. Soham, they will take a lecture of 45 minutes in this room or in that classroom for 45 minutes. Related to exam or recent developments, the primary target audience is R3, all of the attend, and the program is in Zoom, whatever. Every day we will have something of high quality teaching activity. Okay. So we have three, indicated three things. One is the presentation, second is online. By Mangala Madam, third is online or offline by other people. Right? So you organize your interview accordingly and watch this when the quarantine is over. All of you should be talking to our carry Nathan.
Okay. Lecture. Doesn't negate the meeting lecture. Meeting lecture.
We understand
more. Yeah,
that is my
okay. So we are going to do a thing on review of literature. I'm just searching for my PowerPoint. Okay. So, Mike, okay. So we are going to be doing why as to why we will do review of literature, and just give me a minute. Again. इसको डुप्लीकेट कर सकते हैं डुप्लीकेट हो गया आ गया कि नहीं आ गया सो एक्सटेंड क्यों हो रहा
है
आ गया चलो आ गया ओके सो ऑलराइट सो विल डू व्हाई वी नीड टू डू सर्चिंग एंड रिव्यू ऑफ लिटरेचर ओके एवरीवन नोज दिस गाय SRT. So, what's the highest score for a domestic cricketer in India? Highest score for a domestic first class cricketer in India? Anyone knows? So, if he has to score the highest domestic score, then what should be his score? Nahi pata. Okay, so the answer is, how do you find that out?
Google.
So basically you want to search. Okay, so that's basically the thing. So you need to find out. This is an old thing. So the main question was this. Okay. So the score is actually 444. Okay, so this is for test. And for highest score in first class cricket is 445. So this is basically again review of literature. If you're going to be doing something writing on cricket, okay. If you're going to write something, okay. So basically you're trying to find out stuff that is related to that particular area. You are not going to find out the score in one day cricket. If you're looking at a question for test cricket, you're not looking at a score for one day cricket, neither 2020 cricket. So what does it mean? You're not supposed to find out everything about cricket, but only things that are related to what you're going to be doing. Okay. So this is another thing. Okay. How many times both openers have been dismissed in the 90s in the same innings. Okay. And so on and so forth. So you can have some, this is even more detailed. Okay. This is even more detailed. Okay. So as we go about, so the point is this. Okay. This is sports trivia versus research. So something which is serious, something which is not serious. One is a hobby, while one could be a profession and does not cost billions of dollars or lakhs of rupees. And you might get it through some time. And if everybody is searching the same thing, Google will provide you the result at the fastest time possible. Okay. And but research in you require a lot of ethics and time, and requires a lot of money and effort. Okay. So this is a short thing. Now, if you look at obtaining pulse oximetry data in units, a randomized crossover study of sensor application techniques. If you want to get the fastest saturation from a patient, whether you should apply the sensor after the machine is on or apply the sensor first and then turn on the machine was the question. Okay, so this is your pulse oximeter. And there were three techniques that they wanted to study: sensor connected to cable and then apply to infant, sensor connected to cable, apply to investigator's finger. Finger and then to infant, sensor applied to infant and then connected to cable. So they wanted to study these three techniques, and so reason is because during resuscitation, which is the fastest way to get your saturation rate. So what they found, and they found after research, is that they found that best is to apply to the baby and then to the machine. They forgot to read the manual of the product, which told us the same thing. So the point is, review of literature does not only mean journals, it could mean a lot of other things also. You have to read everything related to a particular subject. Okay, so what when you say review of literature, it is a critical and in-depth evaluation of previous work, a summary and synopsis of a particular area of research, and a good review explains as to why you are doing this particular research. So it is closely linked to your research question. So if your research question is, whether you should be giving, now coming to this COVID-19 example, whether you should be taking hydroxychloroquine for prophylaxis. Okay, if that is your question, you will have to find, we can do a literature search related to that. And we are not going to read everything about hydroxychloroquine, but we are going to look at where it interacts, etc. We are also going to not look at the molecular structure of the virus. So you're going to look at things that are related to this particular thing. So you're going to be, so review literature relates to a focused search and not everything about coronaviruses or not everything about hydroxychloroquine. Okay. So a literature review basically is a coherent integrated narrative, interpretative criticism that looks at the current status of knowledge of a carefully defined topic of the selected relevant existing literature. Okay, so this is how it is particularly defined. Okay, so you basically want to do what has been done before and how it relates to your research problem, and to point out specific research strategies and specific procedures and measuring instruments that are productive in investigating your topic. You also want to avoid reinventing the wheel. Why? Because if somebody has already done the work and has already published similarly, you doing the research is going to be waste of your time. One. Second, you're not going to get published. Third, if you're going to invest 2 lakh rupees or 3 lakh rupees in doing that particular thing, then it's a waste of money also. Okay. So you want to identify the seminal work. Okay, sorry. So you want to avoid the seminal works, to identify the most important works in your particular area, to define and identify major key concepts, to increase the breadth and depth of the knowledge in the subject area, and more importantly, to put your particular research topic in context, in context with other particular other research. Okay. And to identify opposing views also. And review must be relevant, appropriate, and useful to you and the research problem. References are only good if they're relevant to your research problem. So there's no point in having bad references per se. Includes only the most relevant articles. Quality of the references is more important than quantity. Now this is very important. Why quality of the references is more important than quantity? Because if you look at papers that are published in JAMA, NEJM, or good journals, they will almost never reference Indian journal articles because they feel that the quality of Indian journal articles is poor. That is one reason. Okay. Second, if you refer journals, if you refer in your references, if you refer articles which are published in poor journals, okay, it means that your way of, you must not search harder, or you don't have access to good journal articles. So if the same journal article is published in a supposedly good journal, you will not, and if you reference an article from some other non-good journal, it shows that you probably have not read good literature. So this is one way of looking at it. So quality of references is more important than quantity. And many times when people review art manuscripts, they will not accept, or they will ask you to change the references. So we have had many times when we have submitted for publication, they've asked us to change the references, saying that the references are not from good journals very clearly. And they have said to look for, or they will give references where, which you can cite. So this is what actually happens when you're submitting manuscripts. Okay. Most recent lecture, both in content and methods. So somebody cites an article from 1985, it is not going to be really valid. Okay. Just a minute. Audio is not very clear. So Bhadraj asked a question whether WHO UNICEF guidelines on newspaper articles as a reference. Depending upon what the article is, you can use newspaper articles. So we have published something on abortion. We have published something on, prematurity, where we have used newspaper articles as a reference, but it is often the starting point of the article and not as a good reference. WHO UNICEF guidelines definitely you can use. Okay, then so deep thinkers, so it will tell you whether how much good review you have done suppose somebody looks at your review of literature and finds your review of literature not gone through the latest or the most important papers does not demonstrate the key factors of that particular area, then it will suggest that you have not done a good review of literature. So it's important. Okay. And you there can be dependence on secondary sources such as other literature reviews may be appropriate. Usually you would want to check the original reference articles. Okay. Literature review is not judged by the length or the number of references it includes. Very important. If you are doing some rare thing, suppose you want to do something on hydroxychloroquine and COVID-19, you will not get lots of references. You'll get 5 references, 7 references. That is enough. Okay, you can't have more. But if you want to do diabetes mellitus and nutrition or something, then you get lots of references. Then you probably have to look at more recent references rather than old references. So that's how your literature review will be judged. Okay. So it's mainly judged in the context of the proposal and the completed studies. The problem, the significance of the study, and the research problem all influence the type of literature review. So we'll do an actual search later on. Okay. So a few questions. What is known about the subject? Very important, literature review should tell the person who is reading your thesis as to what gaps in the literature are you trying to fill. Okay, so in the literature review, you'll have to kind of, in the introduction, you have said why you are doing this particular study, but in the literature review, you should be able to show that this particular thing is not there. Okay, so are some things related to that you can show. Have any further studies been identified or by other researchers that you may want to consider? And what are the significant research personalities in this area? So why significant research personalities? there are few people who do particular kind of work. If you look at in neonates, if you look at high frequency ventilation, there's one particular person in Netherlands who published the most kind of articles on high frequency ventilation in neonates. So you probably would have to read all his articles that is published. Okay, because that is particularly important. What are the significant? So that's why research personalities become important. Okay, and if you have not quoted any of his work in your article on neonatal ventilation, high frequency ventilation, it means very clearly that you have not read the best literature. Okay, so is there consensus on the topic that you're looking? What various aspects have generated significant debate on the topic? What methods or other problems are identified by others studying in the field and how that might impact your research? So this is another thing that to look at when you're doing literature review. What is the most productive methodology for your research based on the literature that you have reviewed? And what is the current status of research in this area? So these are the various questions that you would look at when you're doing literature review. What are the various sources of information? So you could do literature review from, you have to do actually, from PubMed, from Google Scholar, from Cochrane database. You can do it from their database. There are various databases that embase. NCBI is basically PubMed. So PubMed has various participants, so I will show you that. Okay. So these are the things that you would want to do. So you can look at broad areas, or you can, so when you start with the literature, you will see how we do it. You can start with a broad area and then narrow down to what particular kind of people that you're looking at. So if you're looking at epilepsy, you could look at epilepsy in neonates rather than epilepsy everything. Simple epilepsy or refractory epilepsy, whether you can look at diagnosis, treatment or prognosis. Okay. I already told you this, why you want to do, you want to avoid repeating a study. Identify studies of importance which you may want to modify. So what this means is somebody has done a study on a particular subject, but it is not a randomized control trial. He has done a cohort study or a descriptive study. Then you can think of trying to do a randomized control trial in that particular area. So when studies begin in a particular area, you typically won't start with a randomized control trial. You usually will have a case series or some kind of a descriptive study. That's usually the beginning. Okay, you can sharpen the objectives, improve your knowledge and understanding of the subject. And also you want to find out what other people are thinking. So you can reformulate design of your study. Why is this? Because you started out wanting to do a randomized control trial for some particular topic, and on literature review you find that there are no good descriptive studies, or there are some different kinds of studies, or some randomized control trials already done. So what happened in when we submitted some recent study about 1-2 years back on sucrose and neonatal pain, what happened is they said that RCTs have been done and we will not accept the paper. So what we did is next time when we did a study, we did a crossover randomized control trial for the same particular question, and that got accepted recently in Journal of Perinatology because no crossover RCT has been done. So your literature review can allow you to change the design of your particular study. So when should you do a literature review? When should we do a literature review? Before starting the study. When else? So throughout the study, even in the middle of the study, if it is going to take a long time to do a study, it is important to kind of do a literature review regularly. So it is difficult many times to do a literature review again and again. So what you can do, especially in Google Scholar as well as in PubMed, you can set up alerts for research. You will get emails saying that isme ek naya study published hua. That way you can have a constant literature review going on, you getting emails on a regular basis for a new study that has been published. So that is one way to kind of avoid doing literature review again and again. But definitely at the end of the study, you need to do a review of literature, because somebody else might have already published something which you were already doing. Okay, so it would be important to take that into account. Plus, somebody might have published something important which is not similar to what you're doing, but which you can take into account while writing your discussion, etc. It may not change, or you can still publish a paper, but you can use that paper to modify your discussion while you're writing your thesis. So it's important to do literature review again at the time of publication. All right. So you have to have an organizer. So you have to, when you are doing a literature search, you have to write from where you found out. Okay, what were you searching? what are the scope, methods, procedures, what are the findings, analysis, results and discussion, what are the conclusions in those particular areas, recommendations, and you can think of what the researcher was thinking and what versus what you're thinking, etc. Okay, so is the purpose of the review indicated? So that is one. Are the parameters of the review reasonable? Why were certain bodies of literature included in the search and others excluded? So MBAs, so if you want to do a systematic review, then there is a very, very clear-cut guidelines as to what all literature you have to search, okay? And if you have not searched those things, then it is very difficult to get your stuff published, okay? What is primary literature? Primary literature is basically generally original articles or original articles mainly. Secondary literature is you have cited some review. Okay, citing reviews is not a very good idea. It's okay to cite reviews in the introduction of your paper, but for review of literature, it is best very important to cite or look at original papers rather than review of literature done by somebody else or reviews review articles written by somebody else. So again, this we discuss whether they're from reputable or refereed journals, and are recent developments in literature emphasized in this review, and is the literature relevant to the problem, and is complete biographic data provided for each thing cited. Summary analysis of literature, where are we? What has happened? Okay. Okay, yeah. So what are the various things that are to be included in the literature review? Relationship to current study. Does the summary provide an overall interpretation and understanding of prior research? Does the review of major studies relate explicitly to research problems and methods? Do the methodological analysis provide a rationale for the design to follow? Does the review of literature help establish significance of research? So this is in general. So if you're looking at sources, so these are sources. So you have hand searching when you go to the library and look at old journals which may not be available, conference proceedings, reports from pharmaceutical industry, gray literature, contact with researchers and practitioners, databases. So which are the various databases, citation indexes, general medline, evidence base, and so on and so forth. Gray literature can be also there that includes the internet, and also you could have from, so there are various places from where you can get your resources. So we'll do an actual literature review so that we understand what we're doing. Okay, the best way to start is go to PubMed. Okay, so we will do, actually we'll do so there is an updated version which I am not familiar with, so I'm not going to do that. So when you go to the PubMed thing, you have various things. So there is using PubMed, 1 minute. Okay, so you have how to use PubMed is also taught over here. Then you can have PubMed Mobile, etc. So clinical queries is something which you can use for actually clinical work. During routine ward work, you can use it. There is something called as mesh searching. And everyone knows how to do mesh searching. Mesh? Nahi pata? Okay. So we'll go to mesh later on. Now let's look at what do you want to search? Huh? Huh? Migralepsy. What is that? Migraine. So there is a word called migralepsy. So you can do migralepsy. Spelling correct? Correct. So we go to migralepsy. So what is your research? Why you are searching for migralepsy? Your thesis topic. So the migralepsy is only one item, but it has taken automatically migraine as well as epilepsy. All right. Now, so there is epileptic headaches, visual arrest. So these are 45 articles. Now let's look at how we go about it. Since there are just 45 articles, you are very lucky. You don't have to search much. Okay, you can go to per page 50, and you will see all the articles that come up over here. Okay. So this is your micralepsy. So let's look at this. Let's go to the best sort order. So again, you have 45 articles. Here there is summary. You can go to abstract. Okay. So all your abstracts will show. Now I will send this full abstracts, all these abstracts to email ID. Okay. You can see here. Okay. I am not signed in, so I can sign in. If I sign in, you all should actually create an account and log in to PubMed. So you can actually sign in to PubMed. Okay, so what the advantages of signing into PubMed is that you have all your searches can get saved, okay, and you can actually also save a lot of things. So I'll show you in my saved what is there in my saved thing. Okay, look at my saved. If you go to my account. Go to this 50. Go to my account. And you have this various articles. Okay. So if you can look at these are my collections. I have various things already searched and kept. Okay, so we can also this recent activity also it stores. Okay, there are so many other things which you can actually do. So it kind of stores everything. Then so we go to summary. The reason I'll tell you why I'm trying to do this. The summary. Go to summary. Then what happens? You have your abstracts coming up over here. You can also send this summary to by email. What is your email? S dot? H dot? Telling. Gmail. Okay, so check your Gmail, you would have got this. Okay, dekho. Correct, and chovatia@gmail.com. So you would have got this. Now, how this is important is if you click on this, it will tell you it is full text article. Okay, it will tell you it is full text article. I am just doing something here for the beginning. आप लोग VPN use करते हो? So you have got this. When you click there, it took you to the website of the article, but I don't think you have access to this. Okay, it is a paid thing. You will not get this. Okay, you know how to get access to paid articles, right? Illegal way. I will not mention because I am on Zoom. But there are illegal ways. There are illegal ways in which you can get through this. But anyway, so then let me check if I got through VPN. Yeah, so I'm logged in through my phone internet to the hospital. Why it is important? Because some articles are there through the, like this is a finger link article. If I click on this, if I go through Charutar, probably, I'm not sure, but many of these finger articles are available full text because this is download PDF. Okay, this is available to us because we are through Charutar Health. But if you try it through your own thing, you will not get it. Okay, so this is probably a book and you can get it. So this is how you can go. So clicking here is important and logging in through the hospital VPN or hospital internet access is important because you will get a lot of articles free. Okay, so this is your particular. So this you can do for each of them. And next what happens, why is this important? Why is the first step important? The abstract is important because looking through the abstract, you'll know whether that particular article is useful or not. And then you go and download the full text to read. Now this is not a very good idea, good example for review of literature. So better way would be something which is very broad. So let's look at something very broad. What is broad? But anybody has a different thesis topic? Broad, like, इसका क्या है सपना माइग्रेन ही है कॉन्ट्रास्ट इंड्यूस्ड नेफ्रोपैथी सो दिस इज द बेटर टॉपिक टू सर्च ओके सो कॉन्ट्रास्ट इंड्यूस्ड नेफ्रोपैथी सो नेफ्रोपैथी पैथी कॉन्ट्रास्ट ओके लेट्स सर्च दैट सो यू हैव गॉट 27,292 आर्टिकल्स Now this is the problem. Okay, he can read 45 articles, microlepsy, but you can't read 27,000 articles. So we need to minimize this. So how do you minimize this? How do you reduce the burden that you're going to have? So not full text. If you put full text here, if you put full text here, what will happen? You will get full text only for things which are freely available on PubMed. So you might have access to those paid articles because you are through Bhayekaka University. You will get access, but if you click full text here, all that will go off and you will not read articles which are available to you because our college has paid for it. So don't put full text here. Also you could put full text, but so there is free full text and full text. You put full text, so that full text is available on PubMed. It is possible that many times full text is not available on PubMed, but is available through the general website. That also is possible. So, but it may not be a good idea to put it there. Okay, so let's look at, so one very important thing is science is evolving. So you may want to see it in the last 10 years. One best way to cut down is to, especially for people who are doing thesis, is to do in the last 10 years. So that itself will cut down your literature review further and it will be recent. Okay, so if I click 10 years, what happens? Let's see what happens. How many you expect? 15,000, let's see. कितना है 27,000 नथिंग चेंज पहले भी 27,000 ही था ना Okay, 10,000. So this is a reasonable number. Okay. Now what you want to do? Are you interested in children? Are you interested in children? No. Intravenous. So we'll come to that later. So we'll try and look at this. Okay. Humans. Okay. That is one. Okay, 7,800. Okay, we can look at additional filters. Show additional filters. So what are the additional filters that are there? So this net is becomes slow, so we are slightly stuck. So one way is to go to 5 years. Okay, so here you can go to ages. Okay, you can go to languages because you are not interested in learning German and reading the articles. You can go to general categories. You can leave. Look at ages. Let's see this. Yeah, change anyone. Ages and languages. Anyway, so what you could do is this is one way. Now this is not a very good way because so here we are, it has gone to ages. So you are not interested in birth to 18 years, you are interested in what age group you are interested in? More than 18. So 19 plus years you can put. Okay, and so probably it'll come down to 5,000 or so. Let's see. See, 5,000, good guess. Okay, and then we can go to English. And probably we'll get 4,000 or 3,500. Okay. So now once you have had this number of articles, the best way is to probably screen all the articles. You have to screen. So then we'll go and see. So it's contrast and it's nephropathy. So what is the study doing? What is the aim of the study?
Aim is to identify the incidence of contrast and study the risk factor profile.
So interested in incidence and risk factor profile. Okay. So then you can look at what kind of articles are you going to look at. Okay. So you have to kind of, so we can look at article types. Okay. So we can look at what article types are we going to look at. So what you would do is you would kind of remove case reports, case studies. You'll include clinical trials and stuff. So based upon that, you are somebody reported that so and so patient came. So there's a case report saying that he is my nephropathy. You are not interested in reading that case report. So you can, and any actually there are a lot of them would be actually case reports. So you are not interested in looking at case reports, and so you can restrict the number of articles that you're looking at. Okay. We are not getting this, huh? Normally it should tell us. Okay, so that's one way. Now let's switch to another way of looking at this. What is the mesh method? Okay, so in here it is PubMed, but there, if you look at this, there are so many other things that are done. Okay, of which there is something called as mesh. Okay, MESH is medical subject headings. Okay. So what I would suggest is just go to nephropathy. Just go to nephropathy. And not getting searched. We'll go to MESH and we'll go look at how to search using MESH headings. So MESH headings is the best way to search for articles. You will not get into Abhi, so far we have reached what number of articles? 4,500. Okay, we'll look at MESH and see how we can change it. You will not get a lot of useless articles when you're doing MESH. Okay, so we'll keep the filters the same. Okay, we'll not change the filters. We'll go to MESH. Nephropathy. So you know virtual resources are free for Charutarakam. So there is this Springer. Okay, Springer is free. Okay, you go to link.springer.com. It will tell you Pramukhswami Medical College. Okay, so this is free. Not all the journal articles in Springer, but many of them. Okay. Second thing is there is Clinical Key. Clinical Key. Everyone knows Clinical Key. Clinical Key, a lot of elsewhere journals are free. So you could do the same search. The search process is similar, but not the same there. Okay. Searching PubMed is much more easier than Clinical Key, etc. The only benefit of Clinical Key is you don't have to search for very old articles because you have access for only the last 15 years or so. So 2005 ke pehle ke article nahi milenge Clinical Key. Okay. And the third one is you have heard of Enlist? Have you heard of Enlist? No, yes. So all residents are supposed to get free login from the library, which gives you access to lot of content. Okay. This is the Enlist. You would actually have had some kind of access. So coming back to your MESH is still not start searching. I know what's wrong with this. Okay, so if you look at this Enlist, there are all these resources. So you have Oxford Journal, there are around 206 journals which are there. Okay. Then JSTOR is not so much useful. There is this ebook which can use. Okay, then there is a Sage books which you can use. Okay, then there are various other Springer ebooks you can get. So many other things that you can get through. Okay, so Oxford journals you can get. ProQuest. Then Sage, this is not so good. This is Springer Nature. Okay. So ProQuest, this is your bookshelf. So you can get a lot of books also. You can get a lot of books also. Now, nephropathy, if you want to check. Only problem with this ebook central is books are not very recent. Books are like 4-5 years older. You will not get the latest one. So this is 2008. So these are actually textbooks you can read. Free of cost. Okay, a lot of them. I don't know how important these are, but some of the important ones you could get. But they're relatively older books. is this important? I don't know if they're important, but these are the kind of books you'll actually get. These are full textbooks. And you can borrow this book. You can use it on an ebook reader on your phone or your iPhone or tablet and use it for 21 days. And then you can return. You can't download the entire book, but you can download certain chapters. Okay, coming back. So let me try this. Let's go back. Okay, so nephropathy, oh, so you wanted mesh. So these are Oxford journals. I don't know what journals are applicable for. So journals by subject. So if you want to look at nephropathy here, in clinical key, the best way to put is actually put the what you want. Okay, otherwise you'll get a lot of things and it's difficult to search separately. This one does not have the same thing like PubMed where you can put age, etc. But you can search in pediatrics, you can search in adult journals rather than pediatric journals. So there are 6,000 results over here and you can actually go to specialties. Okay, you can actually go to specialties and look at what particular thing you want. Nephrology. If you restrict to nephrology, you'll get 298 articles. So nephropathy, and let's hope this thing comes out. If in mesh, I hope it comes up now. So no one has used mesh before. Okay. So in medicine in Oxford, there are all these articles which are there. Okay. So this American Journal of Hypertension, I think which would be interest to you all. Okay, British Medical Bulletin. British Medical Bulletin gives actually a lot of review articles. It picks up a particular topic and then gives a lot of reviews on that. So it's more of a review book. Okay. Clinical Infectious Diseases. So Clinical Kidney Journal. So this is your article which would. This is free to you, okay? This particular thing is free to you. Then European Journal, there are so many other good journals which are there. Kisi ko pata tha ya ki nahi pata tha? Huh? Nahi, ye Enlist, Oxford, all most Oxford journals are available free. National Library, Enlist, through that, okay? So let's go back and see whatever. I don't know what's wrong, but the mesh is not working. So there's nephrology, dialysis, transplantation. A lot of good journals. All that is free.
You just have to make an account in
this. Yeah, you'll get the password from library.
All right.
Abhinav, you wanted to ask a question?
Sir, do we need a hospital IP to access Enlist, or it can be accessed from anywhere outside the hospital?
You don't require hospital IP. Yeah, you can access from anywhere because you have a username and password. Okay. So now,
okay, thank you. Yeah.
When we go to nephropathy, you have all these things. So AIDS associated nephropathy, Balkan nephropathy, glomerulonephritis IgA. Okay. Now, diabetic nephropathy, Dendry syndrome. Tumhara nephropathy isme hai? Huh? Abhi tak nahi hai na. So this is 20 per page. You go to 100 per page. Because there are how many 31 articles are? I am guessing it should be there. I don't know. Let's check. So this is a clinical kidney journal. So you have the latest. So what I often do is I get the book on eBrary, push it to my phone or my tablet, and then read it from there. But it is there for 21 days only. कहाँ गया ये nephropathy chronic इसमें से contrast कोई आता है? None of this is contrast. So you don't have contrast nephropathy, okay? So in this you don't have contrast nephropathy. But if you had contrast nephropathy, what would have happened? You would have got all your articles that are required through that only. So I'll just show you, for the sake of knowing how to use mesh, I will pick up something else and show you. Let's look at diabetic nephropathy. You have to click on diabetic nephropathy. And suppose you are studying treatment of diabetic nephropathy, okay, and your article is only supposed to, your thesis is only on treatment, not on anything else, and you can actually look at only that. So when you're looking at diabetic nephropathy, so there is a lot of things related to diabetic nephropathy, okay, classification, complications, diagnosis, drug therapy, etc. So you're interested in drug therapy, okay, you're interested in probably epidemiology, you're probably interested in mortality to some extent. You are probably interested in some physiology related to that. Therapy, prevention and control. Okay. And you can add that to Search Builder. When you add to Search Builder, so what happens is all of that comes over here, okay, and then you click Search PubMed. When you add to Search Builder, you have to copy that, whatever comes in the box, control A, select all and copy and paste, so you know what you have searched. So you have stuff related to diabetic nephropathy is 3,778 articles. These are all that are related to mainly to treatment and a little bit of prevention, okay. So you could go back, you could actually go back and undo a lot of things. Let's look at, say, let's remove epidemiology, let's remove physiology, let's remove mortality, just focus on prevention, control, therapy and drug therapy. Put on add to Search Builder. Wait, it takes a little bit time to come, even otherwise, even if the net connection is not so, it still will take some time. We'll wait for that. So if you look at here, it has a particular number. This match is only a diabetic nephropathy. If I click this, it will only diabetic nephropathy come. Uh, Second, what is important is when you select all the topics. Suppose you have what 200 articles or 300 articles after looking at all the abstracts. You need to kind of organize them. Which papers you will use in introduction, which papers you will use in review of literature, and what part of the paper are you going to use. So once you read the full text, you have to say ki, what part of the review literature are you going to use, what part of the paper, like what is it trying to tell you. So you have to organize, you have to create a document where you have to list what you have done with, because you cannot have what you say when you want to write, you need to know how you are going to write. So keeping it just in the mind or reading 300 articles will not help you to write. You have to organize your thoughts. To organize the thoughts, you will have a Word document saying that this particular paper I will use here at the beginning and later on. So you will have to kind of mark each paper as to what particular part from the paper interests, reflects, goes towards your particular topic. Okay, that's very important. So organizing your thing is very important. Zotero, pata hai sabko? Zotero, has anyone used Zotero? So Zotero is a thing which you can use. Okay, Zotero is an app which, yeah. So Zotero is an app which you can download and which you can save references. Okay, Zotero is an app which you need to download. It's like EndNote. You have a Firefox extension too. So for Zotero, so these are all my references in Zotero. If I had to write an editorial, I have used these references. I've saved all the references over here. So this is another article where I've saved all the references. Another article where I've saved all the references. Another article for references. So these are all references which are saved. Okay. It's there. It's free. And you can use Firefox. You can use, so last time when we looked at 3000 articles, we removed physiology, we removed mortality, and we removed epidemiology. So what happened? We are now down to 1000 articles. So it is more reasonable to search for, so this is the important, you know, searching for review literature. If your question, research question is very well defined, then your review of literature search becomes more well defined. If you just sit and search for nephropathy otherwise, it can become very difficult. Okay. So this is your mesh. So mesh becomes very important because it kind of restricts your search tremendously. These all remain less than last 10 years, humans, English, all these remain. If I remove each of this, the number of articles will keep on increasing. Yeah. So Zotero has there is a Zotero add-on. I don't think it is there currently right now. So there is a Zotero add-on from where you can add directly from the browser to Zotero. Okay. This one probably does not have anyway. Okay. Any questions so far? So you can download. So I told you, you can mail the abstracts. You can mail the abstracts to your guide. You can mail the abstracts to yourself. It will be there in your mail, and you can, it remains in your mail. When you click on a particular article in that mail, you straight away go to PubMed and open that particular article. Okay. So that is also possible. I think I'll stop here. Any more questions? So there is a Word plugin. If you are writing in, there is a Word plugin for Zotero. You can use that plugin to kind of put in references easily.
At different places,
the same references. So what happens is when you are writing an article. Suppose you put something, introduction, etc., and you put cite one article. That will go down to bibliography number one. Cite another article. So when you cite the same article again, it will go back to number one only. It will not become number five.
So that citation would be
through the Zotero only. Yeah. So you write on Word document, you import the Zotero plugin into the Word document. So then you can, so your Zotero has to be open. You're writing in Word, and then when you, when then you can go to Zotero. You can go to Zotero. Whether Zotero. Go to Zotero over here. So it goes to one and the thing goes down. You will have it down. Anything else? Okay. Suppose you want to go to which was that first one? I don't know. This is a different article. You can go on adding the citation from there. So this was article. Can actually see it comes down. I don't know exactly what's happening, but when you type, your thing comes down over here. Okay. Okay, here. So these are the ones which will come. Okay. Now suppose this is come here for whatever reason. Okay, now you put this is Bonanno. Okay. Wait, let me check again. Because that thing went down. It becomes 4 again. It doesn't become 5. Okay. So that is how it will go. Okay. So you have to play around with this. You can actually also download Grammarly for checking English. Most of us don't have very good English, even though we might have studied English medium schools. So a lot of things can be easily checked by using Grammarly. Yeah, I think I'll stop. Any questions? So Zotero online. Zotero is easy. There is a Firefox plugin. There is a Chrome plugin if you're using Chrome. What is? Anything else? Okay. So just finishing. Okay. So, any questions? All right then. Thank you. So, Badra has asked a question whether you can just go through the reference without having to go through the full article if I don't have access. I think it is important to have the full article. You can't use a, you should not be referencing any article if you don't have full article access. Okay? That is very important. You need to have. Why I say restrict to English? Because if you use French or German articles, and if you don't know them, theoretically, ideally, you're supposed to get it officially translated from German to English and then refer the article. You can't use Google Translate to translate German or French article and then use it in your user thesis. So theoretically, ideally, you are supposed to get them translated. Okay, through an official translator, have a certificate of translation to use it as a reference in your article. And that is very expensive, so not going to happen. Okay, any more questions? Chalo, bye everyone.